His truth is marching on. He has sounded forth the trumpet that shall never call retreat. He is sifting out the hearts of men before his judgment seat. Oh, be swift, my soul, to answer him. Be jubilant, my feet. Our God is marching on. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Father, give one more moment, one more day, just one more year. With God, we're marching on. Glory, glory, hallelujah.
And this was the song she wanted to have played before all of you. So I would like to invite you to sing the Glory, Glory, Hallelujah chorus part with me, because she would want to hear you share your love for the Lord and come together, and she'd be so happy that you're all here. Here we go.
His truth is marching.
Please be seated. Thank you for being so kind as to wear your masks and practice social distancing. If we could ask just one more favor of you. If you have a device kind of like this one, though not so technologically sophisticated. Look at that. Would you please turn it off? I'm sure your ringtone is awesome, but not in this setting. Thank you. I want to greet you in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ and on behalf of Gloria's family. Thank you. Thank you so much for being here to help share in these wonderful moments. Moments of affirmation, moments of worship, moments of praise to the Lord for all that we've received through glory. Would you pray with me, please? Our God, our Father in heaven, each of us in this room is better today because of glory. That's something vital that we all share. And we are here to testify by our presence of the wonderful, gracious, and godly impact that Gloria has had on our days. We're here to worship you, Lord, to be thankful and grateful, to exalt the name of Jesus, and to affirm again and again our hope of eternal life, of being reunited with glory one day. That is the hope that will nurture us in the days ahead. That is our goal as we fix our eyes on the horizon of our own lives. We long to be together again with all our loved ones in the presence of Jesus. Our God and Father, be with us in these moments. Give us your Holy Spirit for guidance and comfort. Give us love for one another and for you. In great abundance, I pray. In Jesus' name, amen. I want to direct your attention to the banner on this side of the sanctuary. And if you haven't seen it already, you'll instantly recognize it as one of the things that meant a great deal to Gloria. The lighthouse, not because it was by the sea, but because it was a standard, a symbol of the life in Christ. The light emanated from Christ and was reflected by Gloria. And I think that's really the heart of why she had that fascination for lighthouses. And if you were ever a giver of gifts to Gloria and you gave her a lighthouse something or other, God bless you. Those were all very welcome treasured gifts. I want to share with you some readings that Gloria and her family assembled from Scripture that fit along this theme of light, the light of God shining in us and through us. Psalm 27:1, the Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the stronghold of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid? Psalm 119, your word is a lamp to my feet and a light to my path. From 1 John chapter 1, verses 5 to 7. This is the message we have heard from him and declare it to you. God is light. In him there is no darkness at all. If we claim to have fellowship with him and yet walk in the darkness, we lie and do not live by the truth. But if we walk in the light, as he is in the light, We have fellowship with one another, and the blood of Jesus, his Son, purifies us from all sin. From Revelation 21, verse 23, the city, that is the holy city of God, does not need the sun or the moon to shine on it, for the glory of God gives it light, and the Lamb is its lamp. And then finally, from Matthew chapter 5, verse 16, the words of Jesus, in this same way, let your light shine before men, that they may see your good deeds and praise your Father in heaven. And friends, that's exactly what we're here to do today, to see the good deeds of Gloria, the light of God that shone from within her words and deeds, and to give thanks to our Heavenly Father. Becky's going to sing about that little light.
If you know this song, please feel free to join it.
Last 7 years, but many of you have been with her much longer than that and can fit in many more places. Gloria Mae Rose's life began on May 18, 1944, when she was a daughter and a sister. And then, attending school, she became a student, graduating from Washington High in 1962, and then, 3 weeks later, from the South Dakota Beauty Academy. That's amazing. They were married, that is, Rich and Gloria, were married on November 24th, 1962. And to think all of this started as a look in the cafeteria. 57 wonderful years of marriage. And then Gloria became a mother in 1963 with Cindy. And Shelley in 1965, and Kim in 1970. She worked as a beautician, as an extension office aide, and parking lot attendant. I've got to admit, of the three, that's the one I have the hardest time picturing. Right? And as a caregiver for her mother. Gloria was also an international traveler, going to Italy to see her family there on multiple occasions. Gloria was, from an early age, a servant of Jesus Christ as a member here at Emmanuel. In fact, Gloria's grandfather, Grandpa Atwood, is one of the charter members here at Emmanuel. That's a great legacy of faith. And Gloria put in many hours of service in and through the family here at Emmanuel. She was a great encouragement to all of us. And I have memory of a few occasions where she was able to attend midweek prayer meeting. And what a joy it was to have her there. And then Gloria became a care receiver, a difficult task. But she handled all those years, all those challenges, all the frustrations and discouragements with such grace and a calm spirit. Let the same be said of us. And in those intermediary times, she became a mother-in-law, grandmother, great-grandmother. And how we praise the Lord that in those 6 years of her illness, she was able to experience births of great-grandchildren, many other important events in the lives of her family. So we thank the Lord. Those days were hard, but they were good to have her here. And today, Gloria is a graduate. She's a graduate from this life. I would say graduation with honors. And a resident of heaven. May the same be said of all of us. Now I'm going to ask Randy Rasmussen, who has pastored here and is now our executive minister, to come and share the word of God with us.
Good morning.
Good morning.
It's good to be with you today. It's an honor to be here and thank Pastor Brett for his loving and cooperative spirit, and it's good to mostly see all of you. We have a mass, you know. Gloria was a dear dear person who was very active in this church when I was pastor, but more than that, she always kind of looked after me, kind of that mothering thing. And so I appreciated her care and her attention and her love, and I'm thankful to be here and to be a part of this. Please join me in prayer. May the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be pleasing in your sight, O Lord, my rock and my redeemer. Amen. As Brett mentioned, one of the strong themes in Gloria's life was this theme of light. And Revelation 21:23 is one of the light theme verses that the family asked to be a part of the service. And so as I was looking through the list of verses that Brett gave to me, this verse kind of stuck out. Something in it kind of grabbed me. In this chapter of Revelation, the Apostle John is telling of a vision. Someday there's going to be a new heaven and a new earth. The old is going to pass, and there's going to be a new order of things. And in describing this new order, verse 23 says, I'll read it again, the city does not need the sun or the moon to shine on it, for the glory of God gives it light. And the Lamb is its lamp. And it was that part of the verse that kind of stood out to me. I think we can all understand that the Lamb is Jesus Christ. But what's this idea of a lamp? You know, God's light is shining. Almost seemed to me you could have put a period there. That's enough. So what's this lamp thing? Well, I did a little word study, and actually the word lamp that's used here in the Greek means portable lamp. So we can see this as God's light shining, and Jesus is the portable lamp. I thought, aha, there's something more there again than what we first see. My late mother was a music lover, and we listened to all kinds of different music in our house when I was growing up. And one that I remember was Mom's favorite for a while was a man named Tennessee Ernie Ford. Some of you know who he is. That's good. Yes, I'm getting older too, I guess. Tennessee Ernie Ford sang a song, and I remember it. And was reminded of it when I was thinking and praying about a message for Gloria. The song is named, Let the Lower Lights Keep Burning. Let the Lower Lights Keep Burning. And the idea of the song lyrics is that God is this light in heaven above, and we are called to be the lower lights. We are to shine God's light and love onto others. And the imagery really in the lyrics is about a lighthouse on the shore. And the idea is that the earth, you know, God is shining his light from heaven. He's shining it onto the earth. The earth is the shore, and we are the lighthouses that aid and warn others. Two functions of the lighthouse. And so this lighthouse, obviously, is also another very strong theme in Gloria's life. And as we think about the lighthouse, and as we think about Jesus being the portable lamp, and we have this idea then of, well, we are to be portable lamps too. Jesus is our example. We are his followers. we get God's light and we shine as well. We're portable lamps like Jesus Christ. And Tennessee Ernie Ford wanted us all to shine to help others. In Gloria's obituary, it says, on the corner of their home sits a lighthouse that over the years has been a bright symbol of her ability to shine her light and the light of God on all those around her. Well, you know what shining this light is? Love. Love. Another theme of Gloria's life. She loved. She loved Rich. She loved her kids, her grandkids, her family, her extended family, her neighbors, her church family, friends, people around the community. Gloria loved folks. She loved me. And I'm thankful for that. And as Pastor Brett said, we are the better for it. And Gloria loved the Lord. That's where the light came from. She wasn't perfect. Nobody is. But she knew the one who is perfect. The portable lamp, Jesus Christ. And this gave Gloria God's light of love to shine on others. And it was a reflection of God's love for Gloria. That's the way it works. You know, not too long after I started as the pastor here at this church, I was still getting to know people's names and how we do things and where the light switches are for stuff and all that kind of thing. And after one Sunday morning service, pretty early on, someone came up to me afterwards, extremely upset. And so, you know, I'm thinking, oh my gosh, what did I do? What did I say? What did I do? You know, I got all these things rolling around in my head about what is this about? And what I was told was that the light bulb in this eternal light over here was out. It had been out for the entire service, and I should have noticed before the service. And I should have had the light bulb in there and on before the service even started. Well, I'm not the pastor of this church anymore. So I'm going to confess something to you today. I was relieved that it wasn't one of the horrible things I was thinking in my head that was wrong. And I actually thought it was kind of funny that the eternal light went out. I'll let that rest a minute. I'm glad it's on today. I did notice when I came in. And after that, I did try to check, knowing that it was important, that important to someone. Friends, our faith and hope and trust in anything other than Jesus Christ is like putting our faith and hope and trust in this eternal light. This eternal light is temporary. It's a symbol. And that's all it is. Jesus Christ is the way and the truth and the life, and the one and only way to have a right relationship with God. Do you know Him?
Yeah.
Amen. I love when kids answer my questions. Gloria knew Him. Gloria put her faith and hope and trust in Jesus. And that light of God shined through her to all of us. And now through eternal life in Jesus Christ, she lives in the nearer presence of her Lord and Savior. Eternal light and eternal life are found only in Jesus. So today we do not celebrate a death. We celebrate her life, a gift to us. And we celebrate the gift of eternal life through Jesus Christ. And all God's people said,
Amen.
Amen. Please pray with me. Heavenly Father, for your goodness to us in so many ways, your mercy showing us your great love, we are thankful that a part of that love and mercy came to us in the gift of Gloria. And we pray that every good and perfect gift that you have given to us through her will shine brightly. But most of all, we will have an appreciation for where that gift comes from, and that is you. Thank you, Father, for loving Gloria. Thank you for loving us. Thank you for giving us this special day together. And bless these people, bless this family with comfort and peace in your grace and mercy. Amen.
Thank you, Randy. And that, by the way, is not a garden ordinary variety light bulb. If that light goes out, there will be a reckoning. We're going to take some time now. Becky is a musical therapist, which I assume is a lot more welcome than a physical therapist. She has been a great treasure to Gloria and to this family. So as she plays, I want to invite you to do something. I want to invite you to take this time as you listen. Just close your eyes and let the circumstance fall away and think about Gloria. Pray to God in thanksgiving for Gloria and remember her silently in these moments as Becky plays.
There's a lighthouse on the hillside over those last seas. When I'm tossed in,
for the big ships don't sail.
please. Our Father, we want to take to heart the message of the scripture, the song, the message that you gave Randy to share with us, and mind of the light. We want to keep that light burning. Father, we want to keep the memories that we have of Gloria alive. We want to share them with one another. We want to be encouraged by the example of faithfulness that she has set for us. We can do this in your power, in your strength, in your Holy Spirit, and in cooperation with each other. And so we pray for all these things in Jesus' name. Amen. I want to share just one more thing with you. This is a poem from the Yearbook of Modern Poetry. At least it was modern in 1939. But the message is still strong and ministers to our hearts. It's entitled The Lighthouse Keeper, and it's written by Cora B. Metz. Are the lamps all lit in the lighthouse? Were the words they heard him say as he lay on his dying pillow while his life ebbed fast away? Three times he asked the question to be sure they all burned bright, for he knew that souls might perish for the lack of just one light. When the trusty lighthouse keeper was assured that all was right, and he knew each lamp was burning, then his spirit took its flight. When the voyage of life is ended, may I hear the glad message, well done. Your beacon light shone out for others and guided lost souls safely home. Amen. Now may the light of Jesus Christ shine in and around and through you. May that light warm you, guide you, lead you to life everlasting. In the name of Jesus, amen.
In one of our last sessions, Gloria wanted this particular song sang, and she was expressing why she wanted this to be the closing song. And we, Kim and the Shelly and
Cindy,
sorry, my brain, my brain played pregnancy brain, all worked together to help bring those thoughts to a sentence. Gloria chose this song as a final message to remind us all that we are able to have eternal peace. If we follow God's guiding radiance and strive to be a beacon of love and loyalty.
Like you.
mind and heart with pain, to forgive the souls who wrong you, who make your striving vain. Lord, we are able, our spirits are thine. Remove them and make us like thee. Make us.